Education Foundation with featured appearances by NFL players.
Confusing, I know it is, man.
Great job.
I know that.
Great job.
I felt like we had it. I felt like God was right there with us. He never left us. God never leaves us, man. But it's okay. You know, it's His plan. This is gonna strengthen us, and I swear this isn't your last football game. I don't care what I have to do. If I have to pay for you to go play somewhere, you're gonna go play some football, Trent. All right. This can't be in for you. You're such a baller. I love you with all my heart, man. This has been fun.
Once again, your final score, 53-49. The Highland Park Scots make it back-to-back state championships, defeating the Manvel Mavericks out of the greater Houston area, and what some are calling the greatest high school football game ever played here at AT&T Stadium, home of the Dallas Cowboys. From here, the Manvel Mavericks know that they've got to find a way to get back here. As for the Highland Park Scots, they'll go for their third consecutive state championship next year.
It's incredible. This team has no quit in them. I love them so much. I love my coaches so much. And this is a team win. I mean, it's incredible what this team did tonight.
And the way y'all did it. I mean, down 10, right? That was pretty crazy.
It's pretty crazy, yes, sir. And we just got no quit. I love them to death. And I'm so proud to be a part of this thing.
You know, at the end of the day, watching him on the big screen up there, I could see he was all in. And, you know, him and his teammates and coaching staff, you just had this feeling if they got given the chance, they'd pull it off, and knew they needed a quick touchdown and knew they were going to have a hell of a onside kick. And got to give Mateo credit and the guys who recovered it, Cade. It's just special.
In a game like this, it almost seems like, did you feel like I scored too early there at the end when they were still playing?
Oh, there's no question. I mean, we didn't live a second too long. They're explosive. They're an amazing football team, Manvel is. And obviously, I know they're heartbroken, but, you know, that's the way it goes in sports. There's always a winner, and unfortunately one that doesn't quite get there. But they're an amazing opponent, amazing group of young men over there, and certainly have nothing but the greatest respect for their coaching staff and their young men.
Jalen Preston's the best receiver in the state of Texas, and I knew that he was going to come down with it. So I had to roll out a little bit because the DN came inside, and I kind of came out there, and I put a little air on it because I didn't want to throw it out of bounds this time. This is the last chance, you know, and put it out there, and it just came down about 2 yards short, and he went up there and got it, and I thought for a second he was about to score. I know he didn't, but man, what a performance, you know. It's been a really fun ride. I made a lot of great memories, made some bonds that will never be broken for as long as I live. I know the biggest thing in life, only thing that matters is getting to heaven in the end, and I've tried to lead this team in a way that I've tried to bring my friends closer to God and myself get closer to God. I know that I've changed some of their lives. That's the most important thing there. But Hokahe says, a real version says it's a good day to die for my brother, but we just treat his play unselfish, and man, if that one unselfish out there, I don't know what it was, because I mean, you played really hard. You fought for each other, and this season's just been great. Man, it sucks that it ends like this.
Just proud of our seniors, proud of our football team, you know, for fighting their tail off the whole game and never giving up. And, you know, it was just two good teams going at it. Came up 1 second and one foot short. Well, I just told them how proud I was of them, and just that this senior group was probably the greatest leaders character-wise we've ever had. And, you know, they held us together, and that's the result you get, is a team that never gives up and never quits and keeps fighting till the last second. So it was pretty awesome. Yeah, it's a really special group, you know. Like I said, with Harvey, and then, heck, our assistant head coach, you know, he was on his motorcycle coming to work Saturday morning after our first ball game and was just smoked by a car. I mean, going full speed. And, you know, he nearly died, broke his neck. You know, we didn't have him for 8 or 9 weeks. And, you know, he's back with us on the sidelines. All the things these kids have gone through, it's a special year, you know. I mean, to end up, you know, at the state championship game, you know, that's what you play for, you know. We just ended up, like I said, 1 second and 1 foot short.
Your son, how proud are you of him and his leadership qualities?
He's a special, special kid. There's not many like him. I don't know if I've ever coached a kid like him before. Just with his, you know, he's a fun kid and he's dynamic and all that stuff, and he stands for all the right stuff, and he makes everybody around him better, you know, both character-wise and athletic-wise. He's a special kid.
As the whole play winds down, I knew my quarterbacks were going to trust me to get the ball, you know, and try to go score the ball. And, you know, I just came up short. I mean, the ref said I was out of bounds the first time, and the second time I still caught it. But I mean, we didn't have enough time on the clock, you know. But I just don't know. I don't know what happened, man. It just all happened so fast.
And take me through the play. Sorry, what is the name of the play? And y'all ran it like back to back, didn't you?
Oh yeah, it was called 93. You know, I just run a fade. You know, I knew Kason was gonna throw it to me regardless. You know, because, you know, I'm gonna go get that ball. I got it both times. You know, I just came up short.
But what was your thought when you had the choice to either get maybe out of bounds or lunge for the end zone? Is that the only thing on your mind, is just get in the end zone?
Yeah, that was the only thing on my mind, getting the end zone, you know. And they wrapped up my legs pretty good. I mean, I give it to them. You know, it came down to the last play of the game. I didn't do good enough.
It's almost like the worst thing would have been getting out of bounds with no time left. At least you made an effort.
Try to make an effort, get in bounds and go score the touchdown.
Tell me about your quarterback, what a special guy he is.
Man, he's special, man. He's real special. You know, he's underrated too. You know, he's going to do big things in North Texas. You know, I've been playing with that boy since I was in seventh grade. You know, he's a very special boy.
For LoneStarGridiron.com, I'm Jeff Power.
This show is brought to you by the book, All I Need to Know I Learned from My Texas High School Football Coach, a handbook of wisdom for parents, young people, and yes, even coaches. Head over to www.learnedfromcoach.com and order your copy to support sharing the stories of these great coaches and leaders. That's learnedfromcoach.com.
LoneStarGridiron.com. Access the complete history of Texas high school football, over 100 years of information, win-loss records, coaching histories, individual stats, records, and more. Lone Star Gridiron, the authority on Texas high school football.